vida de lo mío. Si yo a ti no te conozco.
Pensía que lo que de lo mío no depende de mí. No, manito, en verdad
hold
que
up,
no.
Hold up. What did this dude just say? That was literally like a tornado coming out of his mouth. What? Hold on, we gotta rewind that because I don't know what in the world he just said.
No me digas de lo mío, si yo a ti no te conozco.
Pensía que lo que de lo mío no depende de mí. No, manito, en verdad que no.
Nah, that can't be Spanish. Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Ricky from the Lingue Blogs. And if this has ever happened to you, where you're listening to something in Spanish, and all of a sudden it just gets too fast for you, you have no clue what is being said, I would like to teach you the techniques that I have used in the past to understand what is being said. What is happening here, I will let you know this from the beginning. What is happening here is one of two things. You either don't know Spanish as well as you thought you knew it. You know, you don't know your vocab, you don't know your grammar, and you just, even if they said it slow, you would not understand what is being said. That can be a case. Or your ear is not trained. So what do I mean by your ear not being trained? You're used to talking slow. English is not a fast language at all. People talk fast in English, like myself. I'm naturally a fast English talker. I always have to repeat myself. When I talk to my family, somebody on YouTube commented, "You talk too fast." So I know that I still talk fast. I try to think and talk slower and try to talk more proper and things, but sometimes I just get carried away and talk really fast. That's why I love Spanish. So you're just not used to hearing something that fast. You may know the vocabulary, you may know the grammar, but you don't know what is being said. So what do you do? If you have the option, you know, you're watching Netflix or you're watching YouTube, listening to a song in your car, press the rewind button. When I first heard this part of this song, which was about maybe 2 years ago, rewind became my best friend. Because it's like, my fear was, I'm like, oh no, I thought I knew Spanish. And I did indeed know Spanish, but the way he was talking was so fast that I just could not comprehend it because I had not trained my ear yet, okay? So rewinding it will help you to understand. So let me rewind it here.
No me digas de lo mío, si yo a ti no te conozco.
Pensía que lo que de lo mío no depende de mí. No, manito, en verdad que no.
Okay, so what I would do, I heard that, I'm like, what is he saying? So what I would do is rewind it, try to catch the first part. So the first thing I heard him say was, Mesilla. Mesilla is this guy's name. He's the rapper in this song, Mesilla. After that, I heard him say one of my favorite phrases. Que lo que? I always say que lo que. I know what that sounds like. Okay, he's saying, Mesilla, que lo que. So he's, you know, greeting him. Then what does he say after that? I had to keep rewinding just to see what he said.
Mesilla, que lo que de lo mío, no depende de mí.
All right. So this next part, he says, de lo mío. Now, if you don't know Dominican Spanish, then you probably wouldn't catch that. So that's what I was talking about when I said, you may not know the Spanish, even if it was said slow. What does de lo mío mean? If I say it to you right now, de lo mío, do you know what that means? Well, I'll tell you that in Dominican in Spanish, it's kind of like just calling him friend or bro. De lo mío means that, like, you're mine, like, you're part of my crew. That's what de lo mío is. So, like, there's a saying in Dominican Spanish, soy de uno de dos. It's like, I'm yours, like, I'm your guy, I'm not nobody else's. It's not like a relationship thing, like a romantic thing. It's just like, I'm on your team. You know what I'm saying? I don't flip-flop sides. That's what it means. So, de lo mío goes along with that. Like, you're on my team, you're on my side. You're my bro. So, that's what he says there. And then the last part was like the most difficult because it was just, I felt like he said it way too fast. But I kept rewinding, and then I finally got it. He said, no te acuerdas de mí. That means, don't you remember me? So the whole phrase, Mesilla, que lo que de lo mío, no te acuerdas de mí. But he says it so fast, I can't even say it that fast. Let me try it. I can't do it. I told you I can't even do it. Like, I can talk really fast, but that line, I can't say it that fast. I would never talk that fast, but in this song, he did. I don't know how, but I'm able to understand it because I repeated it so many times and listened to it. But I don't recommend looking up the lyrics because in real life, when you talk to someone, are you going to have lyrics? But some of you might say, well, in real life, you can't rewind either. You're right. Sure can't. I can ask them to repeat it. I can ask them to repeat it several times. They may get annoyed. They may not repeat it, but I can ask, you know, but that's why I recommend training your ear on your own time. So watching a show, listening to music, things like that, where you can rewind it, where you do have that power to listen to it over and over and over again, that will help you to get used to the regular, the real life everyday Spanish speakers speech. Okay, so let's try something else. There's this this comedian named Dani Rovira. He's one of my favorite comedians. He's from Spain. Sorry, when I first heard him, he talked way too fast, like way too fast. So I had to keep repeating until I finally, you know, got what he said. Now I can understand him with no problem. So let's see if you guys can understand what this guy's saying. He starts off kind of slow, so it's not bad at all. He starts off kind of slow, but he does get faster. So, you know, see if you can keep up.
Tengo que darle la razón a todo aquel, toda aquella que dice que existe un reloj biológico, que es como una especie como de reloj interno, así como metafórico, ¿no? Que va marcando un poco las necesidades o las etapas de nuestra vida, ¿no? Pues con el tema de que he cumplido 30 años, que se me ha despertado el reloj biológico. Sí, tengo ganas de ser padre. Tengo ganas de tener un nene y bueno, todavía no tengo pareja ni nada, pero que yo imagino que en un futuro...
Now, what's happening here in your mind? I'll tell you what happened in my mind when I used to watch these things and not know what was being said. I would try to pick out phrases. I couldn't pick out phrases, I would try to pick out words to see exactly what was going on. So, I can get the gist of what he's talking about here. I know exactly what he's talking about, actually, but in my old days, I'll be able to get the gist of it by picking out those words and phrases, but I wouldn't be able to tell you word for word everything that was being said. So that's the level that you want to strive to be at, but nobody's, like, you're not born being there. You're not born being at that level, so you have to work your way up. So what you're doing is kind of picking out here and there, what do I know? What can I get from what he's saying? Also, if there is a word that he says that you don't know what it means, but you know that it is indeed a Spanish word, go ahead and write that word down in your journal, in your Spanish learning notepad, whatever you have, your phone, whatever you have to retain your vocabulary. Look up the definition and, you know, keep that on your list. So that way, when you hear that word again, you'll know what it means. You won't have to go look it back up, okay? So let's continue.
Una chica que ella se enamore de mí, ser el hombre de su vida, ella ser la mujer de la mía, incluso poder tener la suerte de compartir el mismo techo, incluso por las noches compartir sábanas y sueños. Y que en una de esas noches, mientras estamos durmiendo, que se abra la puerta de la habitación y que se escuchen unos pasitos, y que aparezca mi nene a pie de cama y que me tire de la sábana y me diga,
all right, so that's the part that I wanted to stop on. Here's why I like Spanish comedy, because I feel like if you can understand the jokes, because you have to look at this. What goes into a joke? There are sarcasm. There are words with double meanings. There are words that are said in a weird fashion, like the one he just said, "Papá, tengo miedo." Like it's not "tengo miedo," it's "tengo miedo," no? So, I'm able to understand that. That means that I'm at a good spot, because, you know, things are being tweaked. They're not being said the way that I was taught that they would be said. That's why I think comedy is a great avenue to learn Spanish, because it gives you different situations, and if you can laugh when everybody else is laughing, not because they're laughing, but because of what the comedian said, then you're in a good spot. So, you know, that's one thing that I wanted to mention to you guys as well. Let's keep going.
No he visto una cosa más mala que un niño no es consciente de lo malo que es. Si fueran conscientes eran más malos todavía. Tienen inquina, son nocivos, son maquiavélicos, son demoníacos, burzubélicos, Niños no. Bueno, a mí me da miedo. Los niños son peligrosos. Un grupo de niños tiene más peligro que un grupo de Gremlins en el acopato remolino, de verdad, peligroso. Más peligro que una mamada con ortodoncia, lo digo por experiencia, ¿eh? Soy un poquito empírico, científico.
All right, so I think I'll end it there. He doesn't really get too much faster than that on this video, but there are some videos. If you want to check him out, Dani Rovira. I'll put a link to like one of his videos down on the bottom there. But yeah, he does get pretty fast. You can practice with him. You can practice with another comedian if you like from somewhere else. He's from Spain on this, El Club de Comedia is in Spain, but there are a lot of different people that come there. Bonco Quilongo, or Quinongo, I forgot how his name is pronounced. I don't know, I saw him like a few times. He's one of my favorite comedians from Cuba. So, you know, he's there, that's a different accent. I don't know. If you look up El Club de Comedia on YouTube, you'll find a lot of different people from different places. Another guy I like is Peter Albeiro. He's from Colombia. And, yeah, I don't know. He was just really funny. He doesn't really talk that fast. Sometimes he did, too. But I always understood him because I guess I kind of grew up with Colombian Spanish. Hearing it. Not speaking it, but hearing it. So I'm used to it. But anyways, yeah. So if you don't know the vocabulary, you know, brush up on that. Make sure that you are reviewing the vocabulary that you already have written down or that you already have studied. Because a lot of people will study and be like, oh, I know it. You didn't know it. You just memorized it. Make sure you know it. So go back and do it again. You know, learning Spanish is repetition, repetition, repetition. A lot of you guys ask me how long did it take. Doesn't matter. Repeat. Repeat, 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 or else you will lose it. So you can learn something else, but you'll lose what you learned before, and you don't want that to happen because then you're going to have to do it again anyways. So why not just learn it instead of memorizing it, you know? Anywho, that's all I have to say about that. Hopefully you guys learned something from this video, from seeing the methods that I used to understand fast Spanish speakers, native Spanish speakers, whatever you want to call them. And yeah, leave some comments in below. Let me know what you think. Is it easy for you to understand fast Spanish speakers? What methods do you use besides the ones that I talked about to learn to understand Spanish speakers? I'm curious to know what else is out there. These are the only things that I did, but you can do something else. Oh, also, I do want to say this about subtitles. I personally do not like subtitles because, like I said, in real life, you don't have subtitles. You don't have lyrics to look up. So I never use them. I feel like it makes you more well-rounded when you can figure it out without looking up the words, you know, without the cheat sheet kind of thing, you know? So I would recommend that you guys do that. But if you feel like you need these subtitles, if you feel like they help you way more than not having the subtitles, go ahead. It's not wrong to use them. It's never wrong. It's not even a bad thing to use them. I just personally never use them. That's all that I'm saying. But anyways, yeah, that'll be all for today. All right, subscribe, comment, like, share with your classmates, with your friends, with your family, anybody you know that's learning Spanish, you know, that you think could benefit from this video. I mean, that's all I really want to do is help, but I don't really use social media like that, so, you know, I really appreciate you guys sharing my content. So, yeah, that'll be all for today, so thank you, and have a great one, mi gente. Hey, thanks for being here. Look, don't forget to check out the rest of the videos that I have here to offer for you guys. You know, keep learning Spanish, keep trying. I know sometimes it gets frustrating. Sometimes it may get boring. I'm trying to make it fun for you, I'm trying to give you guys the best tips out there that I haven't seen anyone talk about. So, you know what I'm saying, go ahead and check out the other projects. Also, the song that you are hearing right now is by the guy, B Official Joel, de verdad. Look, another bachatero, you guys know I'm a bachatero. Our album just came out, Los Trovadores Volume 2, is available on iTunes and Amazon. So go ahead and check that out if you are looking for some more Spanish music to listen to. You can find some of the songs on YouTube from the album as well. So, you know, you can look through the playlist and see what you can find, and hopefully you like it. I mean, there's really dope artists on the album. I'm not saying that just because I'm on it, but I'm saying it like, really, I really feel like these guys are awesome artists to watch out for. So, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Go ahead and check it out. And thanks for being here again. Like I said, don't forget to check out the rest of my content and stuff. And yeah, take it easy, y'all.